Hi, Gary Chillingworth here for Airgunner Magazine, Tuning and Country TV. Welcome to Life at a Range. Well, I hope you've all had a wonderful Christmas and we've got a lovely new year heading towards us. I hope you're full of turkey or beef or vegetarian corn sausage, like my wife, and that you've all had a wonderful time with friends and family. And for those of you who are alone this Christmas, I feel for you. I hope you've had a good time anyway, and I know it's a difficult time for everyone. So we're here on Boxing Day to try and bring a bit of Christmas cheer. And well, we're all sitting on the sofa after eating too much and drinking too much and feeling bleh, let's watch some rubbish YouTube videos to hopefully cheer ourselves up. But to cheer you up, just to let you know, I've got to work tonight. Not fair. Right, so what are we doing today? Well, we are going to take revenge on these, the world's most disgusting vegetable, the Brussels sprout. And we're going to see how far we can shoot a Brussels sprout with a TX200 Hunter carbine. Now, a little known fact about the Brussels sprout is nobody in the history of the world has actually ever eaten one of these because of their foul taste and smell. Now, if there are any youngsters watching this and your parents are saying to you, little Jimmy, you need to eat your Brussels sprouts. Look, we've cleaned our plate. We've eaten all our Brussels sprouts. They're good for you. As your parents leave the table, jump on them. Check their pockets because I guarantee you they will be full of Brussels sprouts because not a single person in history has ever eaten one because they are so evil. Well, we've got three here. Well, just drop one. And the only thing they're good for is juggling. But unfortunately, I don't know how to juggle. So let's set some time. We're going to go for 50, 75, see if we can kill one at 100 yards, and then see if we can go out even a little bit further and see what we can do. So enough of me waffling, on to killing some horrible vegetables. Eat meat, much better. Okay, so here we are on our first attempt. We have got 51 yards, got a peg here, and let's see if we can take out this first evil Brussels sprout. We've got the TX200 Hunter carbine, Vortex Viper scope. Well, the wind has taken us around about 2 mil dots left. Looking at the flags, there is a definite right to left wind. So we've used our first shot as a sighter. So let's see, we're going for the left-hand sprout. 2 mil dots. Oh, we literally just skimmed the side of it. So, here we go. Let's move back. Okay, let's, a bit more wind. 1.5. Right on top of it again. Oh, this Brussels sprout does not want to die. And we're only at 50 yards, which is ever so slightly worrying. Okay, I've got sun right in my eyes. I'll tell you what, I don't know if you can see it, but you've literally got a Brussels sprout and you've got two almost touching it on the left and one fractionally high. I honestly could not get that close if I tried. There's a part of me thinks this Brussels sprout deserves to live. This sun, ow. Right, so. 1.5 mil dots. Right, I really need to go and get a hat because I can't see anything because the sun is going directly into my eyes. Okay, so we've got our hat. and now we can actually physically see the target. And I think looking into the sun was causing me a lot of problems. So let's angle it towards the sun, get down on the target. Often you would have a shooter who would be happy to stand and block the sun for you. Okay, so and still miss. This flipping, oh yeah, 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 yeah. It will not die. It will not die. And we finally got it at 50 yards after about 10 attempts. We finally killed the boxy, horrible, nasty Brussels sprout. Now we go out to 75 yards, and as we struggled so much at 50, how on earth are we going to do this? Okay, so we're now out at, I think, around about 75 yards. We just laze it. Yep, bang on 75 yards. So with a 40 yard zero, that's now dropping around about 4 mil dots. And I reckon it's probably around about 400 feet per second when it gets out there. So there's going to be a lot more wind. Also, we have to worry about all the hot air that's coming from behind us, because in a minute you'll see Stuart with his sticks and his mate, and the hot air coming from them will affect the trajectory of the pellet. So 4 mil dots, considering we took like 30 shots at the first one at 50, I'm hoping this one will be able to do it under 100. Okay, so let's block that sun. Where did that go? Okay, well, first shot, I think we went fractionally left. Okay, we're moving around about 5 mil dots of wind that we can see. That's right to left. And 4 mil dots down. So that's 5 mil dots left. We need to aim 5 mil dots right, 4 mil dots low. So let's give it a go. Yes, and there we go. Third shot, 75 yards, death to sprouts. Now we go out to 100 and let's see what we can do. Okay, so where are we now? We are ...102 yards. We've come back an extra couple of feet, mainly so I can get into the shade of the hut, because it's the sun in my eyes that's absolutely killing me. So let's see how many dots down we've got to give it this time to kill our third and final sprout at 100 yards. It was 4 dots for 75, so it seems to be 4 dots every 25 yards. So let's start off with 8. The problem we've got now is it's starting to get quite hard to see a tiny little, you've got the parallax set at 100. Oh, well, that didn't even make it. I think I hit something en route. Okay, let's try again. We're looking at around about 8 mil dots with about 4 mil dots of wind. Look at that. Second shot, 100 yards, death to sprouts. Yeah, I'm really happy with that. I'm not going to try it again because I'm pretty sure that was a fluke in this kind of wind, but I'll take that. So really, really happy. 100 yards, death to Sprouts. We can't go back any further because we've run out of room. But maybe if we can find some land to do it, let's see if we can push this out a little bit further in a future video. Okay, here we are at Moreland District. Okay, we've managed to kill them at 50, 75 and 100 yards. And here we have Stuart, one of the country's top stick shooters. And he's going to have a go at shooting them at 40 yards.
Top stick shooter, who said that?
It was just me, you got it on video.
I know.
Unfortunately,
true. You're right.
Unfortunately, we've lost the camera down range. I think Stuart shot it. So
oh.
Did you get it?
Three of them.
Oh, he killed all three. Look at that. Obviously, Stuart has in the past stated that he's shooting a shotgun, and today it would appear that that's the case.
I need a blunderbuss better than that.
I think you hit the sticks, to be honest.
Okay. Here we have Stuart's friend, Brant. Hello, Brant.
Hi, mate.
Yeah. Golfer turned shooter. What rifle's he got today? Looks like an HW100.
Correct.
So yes. And Stuart's shooting, obviously, an HFT 500.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we're going to go and reset the Brussels sprouts, and Brant's going to have a go and see how he does.
Yeah,
see if he can.
The camera's been taken away.
Here we have Brant with his HW100 MTC Connect. Go for it. You missed it? This is really annoying. Before we started, Brant said, I'll just do a... just do a test fire and managed to kill the first one first shot,
nice,
but I wasn't recording.
To the right. To the right.
A bit like the JFK.
Bernie the Bolt.
Showing your age now.
Oh, yeah, indeedy. I was a young lad then.
He was 37.
To the right.
Was that Bob Monkhouse, Bernie the Bolt?
It was.
It was Bob. Oh yeah, it was the golden shot.
Like that,
golden shot.
Do you remember his catchphrase? Bingo, lingo, clickety clicks. It's time to take your pick of the six.
That old?
Absolutely not.
No, that was from Bob's Full House, if
oh,
I remember
it?
Rightly.
That's weird, isn't it?
You better come and kill this one off.
I might have a go. I'll have a go with the HW100. I'll have a go.
Go on then. You know it's a 40 yards.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you've got to come up.
I followed the instruction on the first one. I was trying to do it again.
Last time Stuart shot, he killed all three in one go. Can he replicate the experience? No.
No.
Do you want me to have a go?
Go on then. You've got to have a
right.
go at this. So
go
I'll
on,
the video.
I'll pass this over to Stuart. Right, okay.
Never let go of your cocking arm when you're cocking, it's bad form. That's enough.
Oh, just to the right. I actually waved off of it. I've run out of pellets. Somebody got a pellet I can
buy. I have.
There you go.
177 in.
177.
Take two.
Oh, that's very good.
No pressure on the sprout shot.
And there we go. Second shot with a Springer.
Super.
Well done, Gary.
Thank you very much, Stuart. Well, we've had a really good time here at the range today. We've been shooting some Brussels sprouts at 50, 7,500 yards. We've had these two idiots come along. Stuart shot really, really well. Managed to kill all three in one go. Yeah, shame you can't do that with targets. Brant, considerably better golfer than he is a shooter. Was it?
I got the big fat sprout.
You did actually. I just thought you're not on video, so it doesn't count. But what a wonderful day. This is what shooting's all about. Coming out, having a bit of fun, meeting the people and enjoying yourself. So thank you so much. Thank you, Stuart. Thank you, Brant.
You. You're most welcome.
Thank you so much to all of you. I hope you have a wonderful Christmas and a brilliant New Year. And we'll see you all again very, very soon.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Bye.
Bye.
Christmas.
Thank you, guys.
That's all right, sir.
Let me just check.